just about 10 minutes.
Riley, thanks. In just the last half hour, a mystery to pass along. The Richmond County Sheriff's Office needs your help identifying an unresponsive black male. Back on October 25th, they say they found the man on Walton Way near 12th Street, taken to a local hospital, but not yet identified. He has Sean tattooed on his left shin, a female tattooed on his other right, on his right leg, with other identifiable tattoos, as you can see in these pictures. There's also a surgical scar on his stomach. The man also wearing a Seattle Mariners baseball cap where they found him. If you know who he is, call the Richmond County Sheriff's Office. First, if I were tracking this developing story out of Richmond County Schools earlier today, there was a fight at the Academy of Richmond County. We've reached out to the school district for a comment on the two videos said to be from today. They're circulating on social media, but we can't confirm what they are. But it appears around 10 students and faculty members are involved in all this. And in the video, you can see the safety and staffers trying to break up multiple fights going on at the same time. Again, not sure if that video is even from today. We're looking into the incident, and the school safety officers also found a pocket knife and a BB gun. In a letter sent home to parents, the school says no students or staffers were injured during the incident. We're working to learn if any arrests will be made. In South Carolina, the Supreme Court reviewing the fetal heartbeat bill. It bans abortion after doctors are able to detect a heartbeat of a fetus, largely before some individuals know they're even pregnant. That bill remains on hold while a lawsuit plays out in court, filed by the Greenville Women's Clinic and Planned Parenthood. They argue the law violates constitutional privacy issues. The Supreme Court heard arguments from both sides back on October 19th. In the meantime, the state Supreme Court is under no deadline to make a ruling in that case. Democrats and Republicans locked in. Come here on News 12, a photography project in South Carolina putting the spotlight on homelessness across the state. We're going to show you how after the break. Riley?
Well, staying dry this evening if you're heading out to the high school football games, maybe the Columbia County Fair, but into the weekend, rain chances are increasing. Have an update on the full forecast just after the break.
And before the break, a special message to pass along. Halloween is over, Thanksgiving is on the way, and that means the most wonderful time of the year is right around the corner. Our friends over at WBBQ have announced their Christmas music launch. Take a look.
Hey, it's Murphy, Sam, and Jody, and you know what time of the year it is, right?
It's Murphy, Jody, and Santa.
Right. You know, we're sitting here not stirring, not even this mouse here is stirring this year.
Music to bring back memories, help you feel like a child again, and create new ones with your family.
And we're not going to use that old light like we used in the past where you actually have to flip the switch with our hands.
Yeah, what are you going to do, Santa?
We got a smart tree this year, Murphy. But by the way, you made the good list this year.
Thank you.
Jody.
Oh, my God.
Our magic word is not the A word. It's the P word, Prancer. So you ready to start it?
Yes.
Yes.
3, 2, 1. Prancer, start the Christmas music.
Hey! Continuous Christmas music starts now.
On Augusta's official Christmas music station, 104.3 WBBQ.
Time
and get a ticket and a chance to win cash. $5,000 will be given away. Find out more at AikenChamber.net.
The whole town's talking about Milton Rubin's 40th anniversary. Join us as we celebrate all month long with huge savings, special discounts, tons of door prizes, and more. It's fun and easy, so let's get moving with Milton Rubin Superstore.
Earlier this year, a photographer in South Carolina started a project documenting homelessness in Spartanburg County, except it wasn't him taking the pictures. Instead, he gave out 100 disposable cameras to people experiencing homelessness. Kennedy Harris has our story.
We wanted to see through their eyes what it was like to live on the streets or in the shelters in Spartanburg County.
In 2016, photographer Jason Williamson created the Through Our Eyes project. They last documented Spartanburg in 2017.
As Spartanburg has changed over the last several years, we just thought it would be so important to continue to bring the project back here.
They gave out 100 disposable cameras to people experiencing homelessness. For a week, they became photographers, documenting their own lives. One of those photographers was George Young.
And I looked it out of myself something that was meaningful. And I shared it, and it caught a lot of people's attention. To me, that's great.
Young spent time homeless and battling an alcohol addiction. His photo shows a rack of bikes. One of those bikes was his.
It gave me a look inside myself.
Young says that moment made him reflect on where he was and where he wanted to be.
I accepted my condition, and that was the most important point to me to realize. Bicycle is what you have right now. And it's good.
He sought help and rehabilitation from Miracle Hill, started a landscape business, got a car, and soon he'll be moving into his own space.
I've done it, I lived it, and I don't want to be like it.
Under each photo is a donation box. You can put money in the box to vote for your favorite photo. Also, all the proceeds go to local organizations which assist the homeless.
For Williamson,
I love the depth of field that's in it.
This project goes beyond showing a pretty picture.
I believe that every person has a story that is valuable, and through a simple disposable camera, we gave them an opportunity to share that with the entire community.
An eye-opening exhibit. Great to see Kennedy back on the air here in Augusta. Let's head outside now for a quick look at the weather and check in with First Alert.
Equal shot and an equal opportunity.
Breaking news out of McDuffie County. The GBI and Thompson Police Department investigating a shooting that happened back on October the 21st. It happened on Holt Street in Thompson. The report says a 14-year-old victim was injured in that shooting, also shot back in August of this year in Augusta. They also let us know the shooting is a result of an ongoing feud between two gangs in the area. So if you have any information, call the number right there on the screen, 706-595-2575. Lighter mornings, earlier sunsets are on the way. Don't forget to turn the clock back 1 hour as daylight saving time comes to an end this weekend. The time change comes. It will hit at 2 a.m. Sunday morning. That means our days from here on out will continue being shorter until we spring forward. But that's all the way in March, so it'll be a while. With the time change comes a slight adjustment to your daily sleep schedule. And even though we're going to be turning back the clocks to gain an hour of sleep, health experts say it can be hard on the body to adjust to that kind of change.
But definitely do not do the no-nos. So no-nos would be doing extra caffeine, taking a nap. Clearly, if you're excessively tired and it is going to affect your ability to function and to work or to drive, you may be able to take a short, brief nap, but we would advise against taking naps and enjoying the fact that you have this additional time for sleep.
So Dr. Rutherford recommends trying to get to bed a little earlier than usual and getting up a little late earlier to help keep your body regulated. So time change coming this weekend.
Unfortunately so, those 5:30 sunsets happening by Sunday, and by tomorrow morning we are tracking a chance maybe for some patchy dense fog across the area. Now look at the weekend forecast just after break.
Nice. Have you heard? The Powerball jackpot now sitting at $1.6 billion, the largest prize in history. While nobody won the $1.5 billion Powerball jackpot Wednesday night, lottery officials do confirm three lucky players in South Carolina won $50,000 each. Not a bad pay period, but Riley, that jackpot's getting out of sight.
Oh, yeah, it is. Record-setting stuff, and I believe we run the Powerball at our 11 p.m. show tonight, Richard. That's right. We usually run the Powerball.
That's when they normally do the drawing.
Yeah, so watch later tonight. If you did pick up a ticket, we're going to have those numbers for you coming up at 11 tonight. Best of luck to you. Hey, nice weather out there for the rest of